Sudarshan, is this the real thing? I mean, is there more of an upside to go, or is this a dead cat bounce?
Yeah, good morning. Well, it seems like the real thing. But first, let me compliment Lata. Yesterday, she was the market analyst and she took the honors in technical analysis also. Because I was mildly bullish in, I was mildly bullish in the Nifty Bank. And I think my colleagues were also so. And Lata twice pointed out that the news suggests that banks should do well. And that's exactly what happened. So good for you, Lata.
Thanks a lot, Sudarshan. You know, my analysis is more fundamental and it usually takes time for the markets to rise. Yesterday, maybe I was also lucky. Go ahead.
Yes. The momentum that we are seeing suggests that we should go and test those earlier resistance levels for the Nifty and the Bank Nifty both. 10,850 for the Nifty and 26,800 for the Nifty Bank. This means that there is a significant potential left in the Nifty Bank to go to another 350 points almost to reach those resistance levels. But today could be a choppy day. There's no sense in rushing into trade if you don't have a position. You wait patiently for those dips, and dips sometimes take the shape of consolidations. So wait for a dip or consolidation and enter on the long side in the market. 10,650 is our bottom line, is our stop for a positional trade in the Nifty. Till then, we stay long. And 26,100 is the same for the Nifty Bank. So the view is take small dips in the Nifty and the Nifty Bank to go long and look for targets of earlier resistance levels.
Okay, fair enough. Sudarshan, what about you? Yesterday, you know, what we noticed is a lot of the heavyweight stocks supported the market, whether it was Reliance, HUL, HDFC, anything that you would trade today, and what else are you looking at?
Well, the sense is after 4 days of rallies, markets could be a little laid back today. So I'm not looking at heavyweights, but when the Nifty rises again, it will be the heavyweights. This is not a mid-cap and small-cap rally. Let's not get confused on that. Focus only on the Nifty blue chips. But for today, I have ACC as a buy. I must point out that cement is now bottoming out. But taking a trade is not easy. So either you take a short-term intraday trade, if it works well, or you get stopped out for a very minor, say, pain. Or you actually buy the equity and hold on to it. But cement is bottoming out now, like pharma was doing 3 months ago. So ACC is a buy. UBL and Kotak Bank are favorite buying opportunities. Both are outperforming and likely to continue that outperformance. Two short sales, only intraday. Cummins, which is in a bear market, and Canfin Home, again in a bear market. I'm not very keen on NBFCs gaining anything in this rally.
Oh, really? Now that's an important takeaway. We needed to ask, it's also about Reliance. Sudarshan, what would your call be?
My call is to invest in Reliance. It's not a trade for the AGM. But at current levels, it's worth buying into. There are two levels for the short-term trader, 1,050 in the next 3 months. And of course, 1,500 for the investor.
Tata Motors, by the way, has hit a new low today, a new low of 258. Is where the stock has hit. So any shorting opportunity that you see here, Sudarshan, now this question is for you. I mean, after the kind of sell-off, is it still worth a short or is it too late?
No, it's not too late. It's heading towards 200. But you need to have the patience to hold those short positions. There can be intermittent rallies, sharp, vicious rallies. But it's moving towards 200. And there is a short trade even today in Tata Motors and Tata Steel. Both are shorting candidates for the day and for a longer term. Yes Bank is a buy. Consider buying that.
Your UltraTech Cement also is doing well. That's up 1%. Yes Bank is an investment call.
It's an investment call. It's also a call for the day. Oh.